UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
HTML tag here. Okay, here HTML tag is the card. Okay, this is the syntax for overall HTML tag. And however, whatever you have after the less than symbol, that will be called as a, whatever you have after the less than symbol will be called as a HTML tag. Okay, in this example, HTML tag is the card and attributes. I was mentioning attributes, right? And here attributes, basically attributes means it will have some property. It will have property, technically we call it as property name, property value. Okay, now here property name is, type is the one of the property, okay, color is the one of the property, length is one of the property. Okay, now here what is the this type value, SUV. Color is red, and this 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now if you able to understand this example and if you able to understand this syntax, that's it. Okay, basically you don't need to remember anything with respect to HTML. But of course there are some basics that you need to remember, but you know once you start practicing Selenium, you will understand by default. Any questions on this example? I hope everyone is following this. If you able to understand this basic syntax, okay, you understand anything in the HTML. I will show with a real example, but as of now, okay, I hope everyone is following this. Okay, now similarly, fine. Now here I was talking about some set of general terminology, right? Say when you basically go for any real application, okay, it may not have these objects. It may have some extra objects also. Okay, I mean to say, there might be some customized objects. There might be some customized objects will be there, and it will have some customized tags. Even in this case also, it will have some customized tags. Even the tags, say if you don't know about the tags. Okay. Basically, these are the by default. These are the inbuilt. I can say kind of a regular tags. Okay. These are the regular tags, but however, even if your application is having customized tags, just forget about them. Just you don't need to worry. Just you have to remember this syntax. Okay, in simple, whatever you have less than symbol, after less than symbol, that is called as HTML tag, and the remaining thing is will be called as attributes. Okay, now see here. Let us go to an application here. Let me close this point. I'm trying to open one application here. Yeah, generally we'll have a class from 1 hour to 1.5 hour. Okay. Yep, today we'll extend for another 15 to 20 minutes. Well, wait till CD loads successfully. Okay, it's still loading. Let's wait for this. Now here, say we have a test case. Like say in this EB application, say we have a test case. Like enter LED TV. Okay. Select some consumer electronics category, okay, and search, click on search button. Say this is a manual test case that we have. Okay, now we are planning to automate it. Now first is enter LED TV here. In the sense, here this is a text box. In this text box, say we want to enter the LED TV. Okay, under this category, we wanted to select the consumer electronics, and then we want to click on search. Say these are the three steps that we are planning to automate. Now just now we understood that here in Selenium, it uses references concept, which is nothing but locators concept, and locators is nothing but we will derive it indirectly from the application. Okay. Of not indirectly, we will generally derive the locators from the application. Okay. Now technically we understood that each object in the application is going to be represented in HTML, and each HTML generally will contain a HTML tag and attributes, right? Now we are basically trying to find here what are the HTML tag of this particular text box, okay, what are the attributes of this particular text box, and in a similar way, what is the HTML tag for this list box, what are the attributes, okay, for this also, what are the attributes and what is the HTML tag for this particular button. Okay, if you are able to find them, okay, we can derive the locators and we can use those locators in the script. That is where I said throughout entire Selenium we are basically uses this concept, right? So here based on this HTML we can derive the references. Okay, let it load. Let me say stop here probably. Now everyone observe, we have this particular text box, right? Okay, I'm right clicking on this particular text box. Okay, if I want to know the technical details, I mean if I want to know the HTML details of this particular text box, Abdul here, I'm right clicking on this particular text box. There is something called inspect element with Firebug. Okay, I have installed a plugin called as Firebug. I will let you know how to install, but as of now concentrate on this. Okay, now Abdul here, everyone Abdul here. And if I keep my cursor on this particular section, this particular text box is getting highlighted, right? It means whatever the section that is showing here, this is a HTML. And what I said, this is a text box, right? And what I said here, general syntax for HTML tag is, I mean, of an object is HTML tag and the attributes. Now, if you closely observe here, sir, there is a less than symbol. Can you all agree here? There is a less than symbol, and after less than symbol, you have something called input. Why it is showing input? Just now we have discussed. If you go here, if you observe here, what I said, a text box is going to have a HTML tag as input, right? And type is going to be text. Now, if you closely observe here, this particular attribute. Their type is nothing but attribute. If you closely observe here, there should be something like type. Can you all observe type? Type is nothing but basically it's an attribute. Okay, here input is the HTML tag and type is the attribute. And not only that, if you closely observe here, what is this ID? What is this ID? What is this class? What is this size? What it is all about? Can you guess? What are all these things here? What is this ID? What is this class? What are all these? These are the attributes. Just now we have discussed, right? Here we understood how that is where I said, you don't need to know HTML basics. You just need to know what is this. Once you see that particular object, if you are able to figure out what is the HTML tag, what are the attributes, that is enough. Okay, just, you don't need to remember anything. You just remember, you need to figure out what is the HTML tag, what is the attribute here. Okay. So here, HTML tag is the input and these are the attributes. I hope everyone is following. Any questions on this? First of all, any questions? If you are able to understand this particular concept, that's it. In entire Selenium, okay, you can just spy the object. Here, technically we call it as a spy, like right click. And inspect element, we call it as a spying. Okay, you just spy the object, and if you are able to figure out what is the HTML tag, what are the attributes, okay, the first step is done. Okay, now similarly we will try to find this particular list box. here there is another option here. Select this, and here I'm selecting this particular list box here. Now everyone up there. Let me right click on this object. Let me say inspect element with Firebug. Can you all agree here? Can you all agree here? Can you all agree? And what is the HTML tag over here? What is the HTML tag? And what are the different attributes over here? Here in this highlighted part, what is the HTML tag? And what are the attributes here? Okay, here select is a HTML tag. Okay, ID, class, title, this name, these are the attributes. Okay, now similarly, now let's try this particular. And moreover, I said a list box is going to have a select tag, right? See here, what I said here, a list box or a drop down is going to be represented using select tag. Okay, that is what happened here. So it is a select tag. Now similarly, again we'll try to understand this particular search. Okay, now see here, what is the HTML tag here for this particular object? What is the HTML tag and what are the attributes? Here input is the HTML tag, and here ID, class, this type, value, these are the HTML, these are the attributes. What are the attribute values? What are the attribute values over here? I'm not asking about the HTML tag, I'm not asking about the attributes, I'm asking about attribute values. Okay, which is nothing but JH-BTN. And here the BTN space, BTN hyphen print, submit, search. These are the attribute values. Okay. That is where I am saying, if you are able to spy and if you are able to figure out what is the HTML tag, what are the attributes, what are the properties. Okay. That is the first level of, it is first level that you have to know. Okay. Now, see, let me spy, similarly, let me spy this particular eBay. Okay, now what is the HTML tag for this one? Yep, that's great, everyone is following, great. And what are the attributes here? What are the attributes? And basically if you observe here, I spied this particular eBay, and this is moreover it is an image. And here if you observe here, I said an image is going to be represented. Images is going to be represented using IMD tag. Okay, and I also said, okay, not only these things, whatever we have discussed, not only these things, there might be some customized. Okay, probably if you observe here, there is something H1 here. Okay, if you remember, we did not discuss H1. This is a kind of a customized. Not only this, there might be some separate things will be there, but if you able to figure out what is the HTML tag, what is the attributes, that is fine. For this particular say, in this highlighted one, what is the HTML tag and what are the attributes? H1 is the HTML tag and the ID is the attribute, right? So here even I don't know what is H1. So even if you know what is this H1 or you don't know, just you should able to figure out what is the HTML tag and what is the attribute. Okay. Now we understood this. Now we are basically jumping into the actual topic. Locators here. Okay. Now based on these attributes, based on these things, basically locators will be derived. There is an attribute called ideal attribute. There is an attribute called name attribute. Okay. There is something called link text. There is something called XPath. CSS. By tagging, what else? There is something like DOM. I think I have listed all the locators here. Okay. Now here, if you closely observe here, there is a locator called ID. name. Okay. Here, basically there are around 7 to 8 locators, different locators will be there. It means different references will be there. There will be around 7 references will be there. By using these references, basically we will try to identify the objects. Okay. One of the locator is ID and another is name, which are nothing but so far we have been coming across. Now again let me spy this particular text box here. And if you closely observe here, what is the HTML tag? Input is the HTML tag. And if you closely observe here, there is an ID attribute. Okay. Basically uses Selenium uses this ID attribute to recognize the this particular text box. Okay. Selenium uses ID attribute to recognize this particular text box. Okay. So here ID is one of the locator here. We'll discuss each and everything here. Okay. ID is one of the locator. So Selenium basically uses ID locator to recognize the object, and the first preference will be given to the ID. Say if Selenium want to automate, say in here in Selenium, if you want to automate any test case, first Selenium will try to use ID attribute, ID locator. In other words, ID locator, it will try to use ID locator to recognize the object. Okay, the first preference will be given for the ID. Say for example, ID is not available. Then Selenium will try to look for a name. Okay, here ID, by using this ID attribute, Selenium will try to automate it. Now everyone observe here, tools, Selenium IDE. In the previous classes, I was showing this Selenium IDE, right? And Selenium IDE is one of the component of Selenium. Okay. Now see here. Now I'm saying. Now here Selenium, I'm saying Selenium uses this ID to recognize this particular object, right? Now observe here. It is one of the way. Can you all agree here? It is highlighting this particular text box. Can you all observe it? It means, now in this case, Selenium uses ID to recognize this particular text box. Okay. However, the first preference will be given for the ID. If ID is available, then generally, while writing the script, here I was explaining about the references, right? Give me a minute. Let me open it. Here in this image, I was talking about references, right? So here in this automation script, generally while writing this automation script, the first preference that we are going to give for the ID reference, okay, or ID barcode, in other words, ID locator. First preference will be given for the ID. Okay, if you are able to use ID, we can generally use ID to write the script here. If ID is not available, then the next preference will be given for the name attribute. Now see here, we'll try to see if we have a name for this. Yes, see here. This, even this object is having name. In other words, here in Selenium IDE, instead of this ID, probably we can take the name also. See here, in the previous case, we were able to recognize this particular text box using the ID, right? Now the same text box, I'm trying to use name here. Can you all observe it? Now even by using this name also, this particular text box is getting highlighted. Okay. So while writing the script, okay, while writing the script, generally we can give the preference for the ID, name, and the third preference will be given for the link text. Link text means this basically only, this link text will work with only the links. Okay. And what is the HTML tag for a link? I think we did not discuss this, right? See here, generally links will be represented using a tag. Everyone closed up this here. Generally links will be represented using a tag. Technically we call it as a anchor tag. Okay. Now if you go here and see here, probably if you observe here, this daily deal, sell, customer support, these are all the links. See, I am spying this particular daily deals. Okay, Now, what is the HTML tag over here? In this highlighted part, what is the HTML tag? In this highlighted one, what is the HTML tag? A, right? So here, what I'm saying here, if an object is if an object is a link, we can use a concept called link text. Link text means this daily deals is a link text. Okay, text of the link. Now see here. Okay, if it is basically a link. Okay, if it is basically a link, generally we will try to recognize the links using its text. See here, link equal to link text, daily deals. Now observe here. Now if you closely observe this section, this daily deals is getting highlighted. Can you all observe it? Here ultimately we are trying to understand, how to use each locator. We understood ID locator, we understood name locator and link text. Okay. Now apart from these locators, there is something called XPath. There is something called XPath and CSS. Okay. These things we'll discuss in the coming classes. Generally among these two, between these two, generally we use XPath. Okay. There is an exclusive session for XPath. Okay. There is an exclusive session for XPath. As of now, here I'm giving some formulas for the XPath. Okay. If right away, if I start explaining XPath, you will not understand. Okay. There is an exclusive session for XPath. During that session, we will understand this XPath in detail. Okay. As of now, if you want to use XPath, I'm going to give two formulas. Okay. As of now, just use those formulas if you want to really use XPath. And moreover, first you have to give the preference for the ID. Say if you don't have the ID, then give the preference for the name. Say if you don't have the name, then check whether it is a link text or not. Okay. Say if it is not a link text, then go for the XPath. I hope everyone is following over here. Okay. It is the order of the preference. First try to build the reference using the ID. Okay. If ID is not available, then give the preference for the name. If the name is not there, then check whether it is a link or not. If it is a link, try to use the link text. Okay. Even say it is not, it does not have ID, say it does not have name, okay, and say it is not a link. In that case, try to use this XPath. And XPath and CSS both are similar concepts. Generally, these concepts we call as location based locators. These are like attribute based. These are like attribute based locators, because these are basically attributes of HTML tag. Attribute based locators, and here these two are called as location based locators. I mean, basically these locators depends on the location of the the location of the object in the application, where exactly these objects has been placed. However, we'll get into the more technical details of this XPath in the coming classes. Okay, and apart from this, yes, there is something called class attribute. Even sometimes you can use this class, but basically most of the objects will have the same class. That is the reason generally we will not use class in most of the cases. Okay, there is a class locator also. Class locator means we'll try to use a class locator here. See, it has some class here. If you close the here, there is a class attribute. Okay, even by using class attribute also we can recognize objects, but it is a very rare case we are going to use this class, because if you close the observer here itself, here we have class attribute. For all these objects, it has the same class, JH-T. So it is very hard to recognize uniquely. Okay, in this application, how this particular object is uniquely recognized using ID attribute. It means in this entire application, this particular text box is having a unique ID. That is where we were able to recognize this particular text box uniquely. But if you are trying to use this class attribute, it is not unique. This class attribute has been used for 4 to 5 objects, right? So that is the reason generally we will not use class attribute in most of the cases. Okay. Yes, we use XPath if you are not able to figure out, if you are not able to identify the object by using these things. Okay. In a similar way, there is something called by tag name. By tag name means what we have been understanding HTML tags, right? Sometimes even we can recognize the objects by using these tags, li, Okay, li here, li is the HTML tag here. Okay, there will be some cases, but these are the very rare case. Generally, in real time, we use these three. These three and export most of the cases. By using these four highlighted part, we can complete our scripts. Okay, to be frank, I never used this CSS. Okay, and sometimes I use this class, and to be frank, I never use these three this CSS by tag name and this DOM in reality. Okay, but however, we can build the script based on these four things. These are called as locators, and these locators will be basically derived from the whatever we have been discussing, this HTML tag and attributes. Okay, even this export. Okay, even this export is going to be, even this export CSS by tag name, this DOM, this clause, all this, whatever the locator that you want to build, that is going to be built on the HTML syntax that we have understood. Okay, based on this we can build anything. Okay, in this attributes, if you can see ID, we will use this ID. If ID is not available, say name is available, we can take name. Say name is not there, in that case we'll check whether it is a link or not. How we can check? If the HTML tag is A, we can conclude that it is a link. Okay, if it is not a link, then we'll build the export based on this structure, based on this HTML tag, based on this attributes, we'll build this export. Okay, as of now, I said now I'm going to share some formulas for the export. Let me create one new sheet saying imp logic here. Going forward, if we have any important thing that we are going to discuss, we will maintain all those important things here under this particular Excel sheet. As of now, I am giving the formulas for export. Okay. Here, first formula is, here you have to mention HTML tag. And here there is @ property name. Here property name, or you can say attribute name. Attribute name and attribute value. Okay, as of now I'm explaining this particular formula. The second formula is contains and here okay. As of now, I know if you really want to use the export, okay, and when you want to use the export, if you don't have ID, if you don't have a name, and moreover, if it is not a link, in that case, you will use the export. Okay, this is the order of the preference that you have to use while building the automation scripts using Selenium. Now, here one of the cases is this. Okay, now let us try to identify this particular search button. Okay, actually, here this search button is having an ID. If you don't upgrade, it is having ID. So far we are trying to understand this text box, right? We are able to identify this text box using the ID, using the name, right? Now we'll try to understand how we can use this export for this particular text box. Okay, just to make you understand, I'm using this. Basically, we don't require to build using export in this case, because it's already, we already have ID and we already have name. But however, just to understand, okay, now see here, now if you observe here, basically I have copied and I have pasted the this formula. Okay, what is the HTML tag of this particular section? What is the HTML tag over here? HTML tag is input. Okay, now see here, I'm replacing this particular section HTML tag with the input. Okay, Now here try to take a unique attribute. Okay, see here I'm taking one attribute here. Let me take max length. Let me take this max length attribute here. We'll see by using this max length whether we can recognize it or not. Okay, so here what is the in this particular section max length equal to 300. Max length is nothing but attribute, right? Everyone observe. Here I'm saying at the rate attribute name. Here I'm saying I want to use this max length. We'll try it with the max length. Okay. See here in this place of attribute name, I'm replacing using the max length. What is the attribute value here? Now see here, I'm replacing this attribute value with 300 here. Okay. Now we'll try to recognize this. Can you all observe that? The background text box is recognizing. Okay. Now see here, we are able to recognize this particular text box using this XPath. Okay. And moreover, in coming days, say if you really want to use XPath, what you can do simply, just click on record button over here in the Selenium IDE. Okay. Just click on record and record whatever the object that you want to build XPath. Say here in this case, say I want to build the XPath for this search bar, search button. Say I don't have ID, I don't have name for this particular text box. And moreover, it is not a link. So obviously I have to depend on the XPath. So that is the reason, say I'm recording. Say, let me say, now see here, now let me stop the recording. Now everyone agree here. Now you can see here, basically by default here itself it is took the ID. This is the step that is being recorded here by using Selenium itself. Okay, this is the line which is being recorded by the Selenium IDE. Now if you closely observe here, the second part, this target, okay, by default it uses this ID. But if you closely observe here, there is a drop down here. Now see here, it is having so many other locators. It has the ID locator, it has the name locator, okay. See here, it has name locator too. See here, by using name also we can recognize. And see here it is being built three XPaths. Okay. It uses three XPaths here. This is one XPath. See here, it is able to identify that particular text box. See here, again it is able to identify. And even if you observe here, there is a CSS. Can you all observe here CSS? This is a CSS locator. Okay. Now here say fine. Sir, still it is able to recognize. Okay. Now we are able to recognize this particular text box using these many locators. But however I said, you know, first give the preference for the ID. Okay. Now if you close the observe here, again these are the different flavors of XPath. XPath using attributes, XPath using position, XPath using some ID relative. I can say these are different flavors of XPath, but we will discuss these XPaths in the coming classes. Okay, and see, there is a CSS also. It means if you really want to build a XPath, meanwhile, say you are not that much good at XPath, in building the XPath, what you can simply do, just open Selenium IDE, record it, and it automatically records so many locators here. These are the different locators. Okay. Now here let us go to the syllabus. Now we'll look at the syllabus here. Now see here how to identify the elements in a web page using Selenium. This is what actually we have been discussing in today's session, and we have to discuss these three things. See here, we are able to successfully identify locating elements by ID. We were able to identify the objects using ID, right? We were able to identify the objects using name, using the link text, using the XPath, using CSS. Okay. That is what we have been trying to understand here. Okay, by using this ID we are able to recognize, by using this name we are able to recognize, by using this link we are able to recognize, by using this XPath, by using this CSS. Okay, by using these different ways we are able to recognize the objects in the application. Okay, so basically we covered different objects here, and I said mainly ID, name, link text, and XPath are the very important. Okay. We can build any script, any automation script by using those four locators. Now coming to this point, okay, tools to identify elements or objects, okay. See here, if you observe here, we are using Firefox. So here in Firefox, we have something called Firebug, okay. Basically tools for object analysis. I mean, what are the properties, what is the HTML structure of an application. Okay, if you want to try to analyze what is the HTML structure of an application, okay, here you have different tools. Say if you are habituated to use Firefox, browser, there is a tool called Firebug. Generally, most of the automation testers, Selenium automation testers uses this Firebug add-in for analyzing the object structure, for analyzing the application structure, for analyzing the application HTML structure. Okay, say if you are using, if you are using Internet Explorer, say if you are habituated to use Internet Explorer, there is something called IE Developer Tools. Okay, let me open Internet Explorer, let me also open Google Chrome, let them open, and say if you are habituated to use Google Chrome, okay, say you are habituated to use Google Chrome, okay, if you want to find the, if you want to analyze the application, yes, in here in Google Chrome there is something called Chrome Developer. Okay, these are the different tools for different browsers. Okay, but in general most of the Selenium automation testers uses this Firebug. But however, if you are habituated to Internet Explorer, you can use IE Developer Tool. If you are habituated to Google Chrome, you can use this Chrome Developer Tool to find the different HTML structure of the application. Now see here. Now we have been trying to understand this particular DB application, right? And we were inspired this particular text box, and we are able to find this ID name like this, right? Now similarly here in these browsers also. Now here, see here, let me open eBay.com here. Okay, here I'm opening eBay.com here in Internet Explorer. And there is something called FTWL. Just in your Internet Explorer, just use FTWL. It is going to open a tool called Internet Developer, Internet IE Developer Tool. Now here in Google Chrome, let me use eBay.com. We'll wait for a while. Yep. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, please post in the chat box. If it is clear for you, please mention it as clear. Yep. This is called as Firebug. See, I'm just talking, loading this. Now everyone up here, I'm right clicking on this particular text box. Here in Google Chrome, there is something called inspect element. Okay. Now see here, when you see inspect element, if you closely observe here, can you all observe here, there is a name, can you all observe here, there is ID, and what is ID? J-AC. Okay. Here in Google Chrome, for this EV application, okay, it is JH-AC, right? The ID of the this particular text box is JH-AC. Okay, actually this is loading like this because I have configured something here. There is something called emulators. Here in Google Chrome we have something called emulators. For the reason actually it is getting into this mode. However, if you see here, you can see here ID is JH-AC here in Google Chrome. Here, even in Firefox, you can observe your ID is GH-AC here for this particular object. Okay, locators will not change. Basically, these are the locators, these are the values will be given by the developer. Okay, so you can use any browser, but here in Firefox, we have something called Firebug. Here in Internet Explorer, we use IE Developer. In Chrome, we have something called Chrome Developer. Okay, that is what actually here it is talking about. Tools to identify elements or objects. One is the Firebug. One of the object is Firebug. Sorry, one of the tool is Firebug. IE developer tool. Google Chrome developer tool. Okay, this is what we have been discussing in today's session.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.